Welcome all to another Basket Microservice Highlights. So we had quite a long sprint, so we were able to deliver quite a few good tasks. So those are the highlights. So just mention them, not sold separately, vouchers at Basket Notification, Google Tag Manager, Events, and EPAC. So not sold separately, that was a really, let's say, picky product that had a lot of requirements and a lot of behavior requirements that we had to implement. But the previous work that we have done with the product validation and how products are being added to the basket, we were able to utilize that functionality in order to implement the not sold separately. Also, there was another piece that another task that we had to update, which was the product validations that is currently done in SKU base. So we've utilized the inter microservice communication. So the SKU base can now speak to basket microservice and check if we have products in the basket. So we could allow that NSS product to be added to the basket. Another topic, another task that we've implemented was vouchers. This was a really good feature because we had to create a contract beforehand, and we were able, Phoenix team and Basket team, to be able to work on the same feature at the same time without having any issues. So Phoenix delivered the voucher, their part, and Basket delivered their part. So we were able to merge those and deliver the whole experience for the users. Again, we utilized the inter microservice communication for the voucher validation and the mark use of the voucher. So that was Basket microservice to SKU base. Another feature was the at basket notification. At basket notification was a feature that was implemented in SKU base, but using the CES system that we had, it was pretty straightforward not to sit down and try to figure out and add extra functionality when we are actually adding the product, but when the event is being fired. We have a specific file, a JavaScript file, which handles all the notifications. So it was a matter of going in there and utilizing the functionality that we want. So that brought us a pretty good decoupled functionality from the rest of the system that we have. Okay, let's demonstrate that. Okay, so this is a preview page. So when we add a product to the basket, you can see that we have the add basket notification, and we were also able to add that functionality on all add to basket. So no matter where the add basket button is, we can get the notification from that. We have added quite some logic here in order to be able to position the notification where there is available space. So it might be on the side in some cases from landscape mobiles, for example. So now that we have those. Okay, so, and this is the promotion. So when you go to the basket page, we can see now that we have a link, promotion code. If you click, you get the option to add one. So when we click redeem, we send a request to the Basket microservice, which picks up that voucher code and then communicates to SKU base to validate that voucher. If everything is all right, then we're getting back the response from SKU base with all the values updated. So we present the new price for the user here. So another feature that we've implemented is the Google Tag Manager. So we were able to implement the enhanced e-commerce tags in Google Tag Manager. We send that information to Google Analytics. So currently we can track the basket user journey and also track the checkout user journey. For the basket side, we use SES because we are firing all the events that we wanted. So once the event is being fired, we are pushing that notification to Google Tag Manager, and it's being distributed to all the tags that we have we're using. And also we were able to track all the checkout user journey. In order to do that, we haven't made any changes to the checkout. We were able through Google Tag Manager to extract information from the checkout JavaScript and literally generate and fire all the events based from the Google, from the history chains. So nothing changes on checkout in order to be able to do that. And those are some screenshots from the information that we're getting. This is the shopping behavior. So here we can see all the sessions with product views, all the add to carts, the checkout, and the transactions. So we can follow the user journey. And another one is the checkout behavior. So we have defined funnels for each step. And once that events are being raised from the checkout page, we're capturing those and we can map exactly what's going on.
Are the settings for trackers different from Skewbase, or are they on Basket Mercers, or is it sent by Skewbase?
No. We have created a file, a JavaScript file, that listens for specific events through the SES system and fires the e-commerce events to Google Tag Manager. But it is like half-half. So half of those are in Skewbase and half of those are in Google Tag Manager. So we have the option to go to Google Tag Manager and configure to put JavaScript there or capture all the clicks or any events that are occurring on that page and fire specific events that we want without touching the page if we want. It's really impressive. If you have time to spend and go through that, it's really amazing, really amazing. So another thing that we've introduced, not introduced, but implemented, we say, it's the events. So thanks to Alex, that he had implemented, updated how we are logging some events. So we've implemented the same functionality. We are raising events during the actions that are occurring on the backend system, and we are having listeners for the logging. So when we add a product to the basket or we're removing something from the basket, we're keeping a log of that. But we try to make that, to take that one step further. So we started using the events and the listeners in order to add more functionality. So for example, when you add a product to the basket, we are updating the expired date of the list. So in that way, we can decouple some functionality that we want and only wire that based on events. So that will make our code cleaner, less dependencies, and decoupled from other stuff. And it's really, really good because we can properly create nice diagrams on the flow of how things are occurring at on the back end. So it's really, really nice stuff. And the last one is Behat. So we wanted to create a safety net for developers. Okay, so QA team is making an amazing work QAing all the whole user journey and how Skewbase and Basket and Checkout is working, but we don't have a test suite for the API. So we wanted to add that as part of the developer's responsibility. So we've created a basic Behat. We found a really good library where we can go and test the API. And we've started by creating a test for the ping endpoint. So that should be, we will add that to the skeleton project. So that will be part for all the microservices that we're building from now on. So if anyone wants to start using that, the tool will be there. And we were able to start writing tests for the API. So let me, here are some scenarios that we started to write. So the first one on the right is literally the pink scenario. So it's really easy. I don't know if any of you had the chance to take part of the previous workshop about Behak. But yeah, so this is a simple scenario about the ping to ensure that when we call that endpoint, we're getting a 200 response, and the response body contains a JSON, and we are defining what the response should be. And on the left, we have an attempt to add a product to, ignore the top one, just a second, to add a product to the basket list, where we are defining the request body, and at the bottom we are defining the endpoint, the method, and we're getting the response to be 201. So, if you run that, we have written a couple of more tests. But here's the last example of what we have so far. And if everything is all right, then all is green and you're getting. So that will give us a really good benefit when we're deploying on our API. At the end of the day, run the Behak test and ensure that the API is working as expected. And that will bring more confidence to the developers as well. That's it.